एस्ट्रोलॉजी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट राहु, राहु एज अ मिरेकल. नाउ इन हिंदी और संस्कृत इट इज कॉल्ड पारस मनी. पारस मनी इज सच अ मेटल, टू हुम इट टच इट कन्वर्ट इन टू द गोल्ड. इफ इट टच टू द आयरन एंड स्टील इट बिकम द गोल्ड. सो दैट मिरेकल हैज अ पारस मनी, इट इज कॉल्ड पारस मनी मिरेकल. सेम राहु इज ऑल्सो हैविंग दैट मिरेकल्स. वी हैव डन सो मेनी वीडियो अबाउट द राहु एंड स्टिल देर आर मेनी थिंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द राहु. सो दैट इज वाई आई केम विद दिस सब्जेक्ट दैट टू हुम द राहु एज अ एसोसिएशन दैट विल चेंज एंटायर लाइफ. सो टू गेट द मैक्सिमम रिजल्ट ऑफ अ राहु और मैक्सिमम रिजल्ट ऑफ सच अ प्लेनेट यू हैव टू सी हाउ द राहु एज प्लेस. We all know Rahu is our subconscious mind. So whatever run in our subconscious mind, this all are reflective as a Rahu. In my first video, 5 years before, I have done about a Rahu, where also I said that Rahu is a reflector. It absorbs the energy of the associate planet and then he produces himself as that planet. So that booster the Rahu is. Rahu always activates the other planet. So that is why it is a very, very powerful planet in the chart. Many people and many astrologers also make scare to the people that see because of the Rahu you are suffering, because of the Rahu you are suffering. No, Rahu is always a nature. If you surrender to the nature, if you follow the principle of nature, then you will never be cursed by the Rahu. See, who is the Rahu? As I mentioned you, it's your subconscious mind. It is your inner voice. Many times while we are doing certain things, we always get a voice, no, no, don't do this. Or why don't you do this? So both the side thoughts comes. This is all because of the Rahu. He always foreseen that this is the implication. If you do this, you will be going to suffer for this. So Rahu is not the wrong. It is the association with which the Rahu is being associated. So always listen to your heart. Listen to your inner voice. Listen to the nature. As an example, I say that to tell lies is a wrong deed. While you are telling the lies, you know that this will going to harm somebody. So that is your subconscious mind and still you are pursuing. That means Rahu is looking everything and then you have to suffer. It has all the indriyas. See, all the 5 indriyas, senses is with the Rahu. So it will always be very hyper, very active. When you all the 5 sense work in the same level, then you can imagine how much energy it has, and Ketu has no senses, so it is somewhat a peaceful, dry planet. So here we are talking about the Rahu. Now for looking the Rahu in your chart, you have to see 2 major bifurcation. One is that whether the Rahu is alone or whether Rahu is with some association. When you see that Rahu is with someone, first we'll see if Rahu is alone. When your Rahu is alone, then it is very, very crucial and very much caretaking planet you have to follow. Because the person to whom this Rahu is in alone, it's alone, there is no association with the Rahu. He is thinking so many things which deep into the mind which never reflect outside. So that's why it is somewhat dangerous that you cannot imagine what the other is thinking. When you know that, yeah, he is having some association and he is with the good people, he is with the bad people, so you can judge. But here, the Rahu, when it is alone, you are listening your inner voice, not always being you are right. You may have seen that people under the depression, people under the schizophrenic, emotional things, psychological effect, they run their own world. They lost. We call it as they are lost. So they are the people having the Rahu alone, and that is why to whom to ask, you don't know. That is why in my one video I say that who's having, in my marriage series I say, whose Rahu is in ascendant, you should always help them because they are not aware what they are doing, what their direction is there. So here, when Rahu is alone, you have to think that what kind of things he is doing. So he should always be open, he should always be, he has to exercise, he has to do lot of meditation to bring the energy outside. So that is a remedy for the lonely or alone Rahu. So that you have to keep one side. The another side of a Rahu is that when it is associated with some planet. when it is associated with some planet, it acts as like a booster. See, sometimes what happens that one planet is already having, and when Rahu attacks with that planet, it also boosts that planet and also absorbs. As I my video in Rahu video, I say Rahu is an absorber. It absorbs the energy and reflects like that planet. So he act as like a he as a that planet. So not to confuse with this, we are going to see how this Yuti, how this combination with the Rahu planets get affected. First of all, when we talk about Sun and Rahu, when Sun and Rahu is together, we call it as a Grahan dosha. Grahan means to absorb. Because Sun can absorb light of other planet, whereas Rahu is a shadow which absorb the light or which make the shadow over the Sun. That is why we call it as an eclipse. Eclipse, we all know it is because of the Rahu Sun. So Rahu Sun create the eclipse, and because of this eclipse, the Sun heat, Sun ego, Sun power being absorbed by Rahu. And Rahu is the nature, we say. So he will be, if this Yuti is in the own sign of Sun, exalted sign of a Sun, or friendly sign of a Sun, then his soul is being guided by his subconscious mind. That is why the people of a spiritual nature, those having a spiritual inclination, spiritual level, this is a very good combination. But otherwise, people will be a sick, because Sun is for the immunity and vitality, it absorbed by the Rahu, so he will not get benefit. So, if otherwise, if the Sun is already weak, and if Rahu associates with it, also gives the defamation, it also gives the less confidence level, and health wise also immunity vitality wise he is lower. So, it is both the side, but normally it has seen that it boosts the soul. They aware the light of the Sun, soul. So, there is one way, it is a very good. Being it's a ego of a Rahu Sun will be absorbed by Rahu, so it will be benefit for the person. So this will be the good combination. Now talking to the Moon Rahu, in my Natural Healers, you may see that video very beautifully made, Natural Healers. So Moon Rahu, I said they are the Natural Healers. Because Moon, we know it's a conscious mind and Rahu is subconscious mind. When both are together, when your emotions joined with your subconscious mind, you can plant anything. You are the nature healer. If you give anybody's advice, if you give somebody's counseling, advising, they will benefit like anything. That is why all the counselor, all the people like a yoga teacher or meditation counselor, they all have a good Moon Rahu. Both exalted in the Taurus. Moon also exalted and Rahu also exalted. So that is also a very good combination. When both are exalted, they have a lot of awareness, a lot of the emotions they are absorbing. So those people having the depression and this, they should meet this kind of a people having a Moon Rahu. So it will absorb all the extra emotion from the others and they will make the other people more happy. So Moon Rahu is always being considered good. Except in the Scorpio, when Moon Rahu is there, it is a debilitated Moon Rahu, and there it is very lower emotions is there, and that is also being drawn negatively by the Rahu. So Moon Rahu again is a very good combination. Why our Rishi Muni has said it is bad? Because you don't know the capacity of the person. If he can use manifest in negative sense, it works on the negative side also. If he manifest for the good things, it works for the good also. So one has to think, one has to image whether I have to use this energy in the positive sense or negative sense. For that purpose, it has given that it is very powerful you. So it is very powerful Moon Rahu, and they are natural healers and gives very positive energies to others. Considering Mars Rahu, see Mars Rahu, we all know it is Akasmat Yog or accident Yog. Why accident? Because Mars already have too much energy. When Rahu also join, there will be two Mars, and because of the two Mars, it accelerates like anything. See, Mars is full of energy, full of enthusiasm, full of bodily heat. And when Rahu joined this, it accelerated that. You can image a car where brake fails. When you are on the top speed, fifth gear or top speed, 120, 140, and suddenly you realize, oh, your brake has failed. What could happen? Accident. That's Rahu becomes double accelerator. Mars also speed, Rahu also accelerate that speed, and that caused the accident. So that is called accident. You have anything which happens suddenly is a Mars Rahu. So Mars Rahu people, we cannot expect anything. They can do anything. Energetic people. Many parents comes to me and they say, oh, this is not listening anything. He doesn't sit at one place. Give some advice. This is Mars Rahu. The advice is that occupy his energy into the different things. Make him into sports personality. Make him physically active. See, all the army, navy and people where the physical strength is more required, you occupy them so that their energy get consumed and they will not hang. They will not hang themselves. Because a lot of energies are there. That energy has to flow. So that is Mars Rahu. It is a negative impact also that people are so much hyper, they can cause any harm also. So we have to see in which sign it is. Now talking to the Mercury Rahu. Again a very beautiful yoke, Mercury Rahu. Extra intelligent. See, Mercury itself is intelligent, and when the Rahu touch with, they are also very close friend to each other. See, both origin is Moon. Moon Sun is Mercury and Moon other Sun is when you talk about the logical things is Mercury, and when you talk illogical it is a Rahu. So here logical, illogical both joined together, so he can create a miracle. See, all today's IT people, you will find Mercury Rahu, software engineer, artificial intelligence, and all kind of IT related, network related things are there. See, that is today. After 2000 we see that's networking, data, artificial intelligence, all this server and all thing came. Before that, when Mercury Rahu is together, they are extra intelligent marketing people. They are having so many ideas where they connect the people. So all the marketing strategy people, they are the Mercury Rahu. When you need some extra advice, not normal, as totally abnormal, total a different dimension, you approach the Mercury Rahu. Highly intelligent, and both are very close friends, cannot be segregated, because we know that Rahu is exalted in the Gemini. We feel, because in Taurus also it is exalted said, and in the Mercury sign also it is called, because it's a close friendly sign with each other. So that is why when Mercury Rahu is there, today's IT people, artificial intelligence, all these are outcome of a Mercury Rahu. Very intelligent people. Talking to the Jupiter Rahu, it is called Chandal Yoga. In the text it is said that Chandal Yoga. Why it is called Chandal Yoga? See, Chandal means the person who is having everything but doesn't feel that he is having something. So one side the Jupiter is a growth. We all know Jupiter is a growth, whereas Rahu is shrinking. So the person never realizes whether he is in the growth side or it's in the shrinking side. Jupiter, we all know, it's a planet for giving all these things. It's a mentor, it's a guru. And many times it is found that the person who always having some competition with the guru, he always feel himself as a competitor, not as a guru. So they all have a Guru Rahu Chandal Yoga, where Rahu always try to accelerate, and he wish to accelerate, and he wish to go beyond his guru, beyond his mentor. So sometime many people advise me also. So I believe that, oh, he might be having Jupiter Rahu. So that is why he is having more knowledge than me. And many people are there who gives me so much knowledge. I am thankful to them. Because see, I am also a human being. I can also restrict my knowledge. So many people gives me also that, why don't you see this way? Why don't you make the video this? I will be highly obliged and highly thankful to them who has criticized. Many people in the initial has criticized about my English language, and because of them, today I improve a lot. You may also have seen. Okay, that's a part. So Jupiter Rahu is a person having a Guru Rahu, we call as an anti-social yoga also. They always feel that why to follow these rules, society rules. I should go in the different way. So those who have part this religious, who has made his own path, they all have a Jupiter Rahu. It is a good yoga, but people doesn't accept them, because normally people goes with the established principle, whereas they don't follow the established principle. They have their own thoughts, and that is why Rahu doubleted in the Sagittarius sign. Why? Because Jupiter always say go with the straight way, whereas Rahu want the shortcut. फास्ट वे. सो दिस इज द गुरु राहु चंडाल योग. चंडाल योग में दोज हु हैविंग एवरीथिंग बट डजंट फील दैट आई हैव एवरीथिंग. सो दे डोंट रियलाइज वन साइड इट इज ग्रोइंग, वन साइड इज अब्सॉर्बिंग. सो देर इज नथिंग इन द हैंड दैट हैपन्स. सो दैट इज वाई गुरु राहु चंडाल योग इज देयर. देन स्पीक अबाउट द वीनस राहु. अगेन इज अ वेरी पावरफुल योग. इट इज कॉल्ड विकार योग. इन द संस्कृत इन द टेक्स्ट विकार मीन्स समथिंग विच इज बैड, विच इज वायरस. नॉर्मली इन द वायरस ऑल्सो वी कॉल एज अ विकार. सो विकार योग मीन्स समथिंग विच इज गोज एक्सट्रीम. सी वेन यू हैव अ हैबिट एंड दैट हैबिट इफ इट बिकम्स अ एडिक्शन इट इज अ विकार. सो हियर इट इज अ वीनस राहु. इट इज अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल योग. दे आर आर्ट लवर्स. यू सी द मर्क्यूरी राहु एक्स्ट्रा इंटेलिजेंट, वीनस राहु एक्स्ट्रा आर्टिस्ट. यू नो द पैरेलल सिनेमा इज देयर. दे आर मोर डेप्थ इन टू द आर्ट्स एंड क्रिएटिविटी बट दे नेवर गेट आउटसाइड. दे नेवर गेट द नेम फेम एज द कमर्शियल सिनेमा और कमर्शियल आर्टिस्ट गेट बट दे हैव इन बिल्ट सो मच आर्ट्स. सो वीनस इज समवॉट अ प्लेजर एंड राहु मीन्स समथिंग एक्स्ट्रा दैन प्लेजर. सो दे ऑलवेज फाइंड सम न्यू वे ऑफ गेटिंग द प्लेजर. दैट इज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ विकार. वैन यू टर्न फ्रॉम द हैबिट टू द एडिक्शन दैट स्मॉल हेयरलाइन इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ अ वीनस राहु. इट इज इट हैज गिवन अ सो मेनी गुड प्रोड्यूसर, सो मेनी गुड आर्टिस्ट क्रिएटर्स. सो दिस ऑल आर द वीनस राहु. एंड यू मे सी दैट दोज हु क्रिएट समथिंग डिफरेंट we call it as a weird, this all are the Venus Rahu, which we cannot image, we cannot thought. So whatever the arts is there, if you able to produce in the different way, it's a Venus Rahu. And today you see the fighting scene, love scene, all has something different dimension. The fighting scene, you can see that one is punching and the person is just flying. This all are a Venus Rahu creativity. It has also a bad sign also, like many movies which normally we don't see, the other cinema which I cannot name it, this also a Venus Rahu. And many artists also famous because of the Venus Rahu in that particular segment. So that is also Venus Rahu is there. So very good combination, very close friend. Venus Rahu is a very close friend. And you may see all the artists might have some or the other defamation, some addiction, some negativity because of the Venus Rahu. Talking lastly to the Rahu Saturn. Saturn Rahu we call as a Srapit Dosh, curse. Because Saturn is a planet of deeds and Rahu exposed that deeds. So what happened? Whatever you have done in the earlier life, normally it has to pass for the life to life. If in one life if you get a Saturn Rahu, those are the lucky person because their deeds, bad deeds, wrong deeds, pending karmas will expose, it will come out. It is not good that your pending karmas and bad karmas will come out and at least you get release out of it. That is Saturn Rahu. Some curse, you have done something, you have hurt someone, you have done some bad deed to the some soul and that thing you have to suffer. Many times we see that I have not done anything wrong in this my life, why I am suffering? It is not about this life. Because soul continues the body to body. So it may be a past life or other life where you have done something and this Saturn Rahu, this life you are going to face this. Whenever the Saturn Dasha comes, Rahu Antar comes or Rahu Mahadasha in Saturn sub period you have to face. Or Saturn mature by 36 and Rahu mature by 42. Between 36 to 42 they have to face, they have to suffer. And after 42 they release from all the past deeds and enjoy like anything. So 42 to 48 Rahu Ketu period they enjoy like anything. So Saturn Rahu one side it is called as a curse, but other way you able to pay back to whom you have taken something and it was being paid. So is it not a good that you able to pay your past deeds and release from your past deeds? That better the Saturn Rahu is there. So Saturn Rahu always a Srapit Dosh, but they are also a close friend and you will always get a good result when you turn 42. So after 42 Rahu mature, Saturn mature and gives you all positive result. So this is all the association with the Rahu and how it boosts the other planet energy. Now Rahu if it is alone, you have to see which sign it is, because it absorbs. If it doesn't get any portion, then it absorbs the sign energy. Constellation, nakshatra, in which nakshatra it is placed, that is also being affected. To whom Rahu is aspecting, that is also get affected. So Rahu is always being good if it is placed in the Taurus, Gemini, Virgo, Libra, Capricorn, Aquarius. The six people having the Rahu in this sign, they are having a very good sign. So Taurus, Gemini, Virgo, Libra, Capricorn, Aquarius. Means sign of a Venus, Mercury and Saturn. Rahu is like anything. And it will give you an extra result, positive result. About. Other sign, it cannot produce good because it's having no good association with the Rahu. So Rahu has to create something which other planet doesn't like. So Rahu aspect, Rahu Yuti, Rahu Pratiyuti and Rahu triangle. These three things create miracles if you notice carefully. Because Rahu aspect is in triangle, it aspect in the 7 and 5, 9. 1 it will place, 5 and 9 it will aspect. So that is why it's in triangle, Rahu affects. So Rahu Yuti, best result, Rahu Pratiyuti, half result and Rahu triangle, 1/4 result. You will get a boost from the Rahu. So to get the real meaning of a Rahu, that is why I created this video. That is an additional knowledge I got during this 5 years, how the Rahu works. And I found that this is a very important aspect of the Rahu, that is why I come forward and give you this knowledge. Do see in other chart and don't see the Rahu as a villain. You see he is a very potential planet and it has a nature. It has its own nature. If you follow his nature, he will never be suffering anything. And Rahu is also one of a planet who immediately gives you the result. If you do some remedy for the Rahu, it will always give the blessing. That is why Rahu remedy is very easy to perform. So do pray Rahu, do surrender to the nature, follow the principle of nature. Rahu will never curse you, Rahu will never face you any problem. Listen to your inner voice, listen to your heart, then Rahu will never cause you any harm. And I have practiced that and I have seen the very good result about the Rahu. That is why I am giving this knowledge to you, and do share this to others. I hope you like this video, this concept, and do apply it, see it and tell others also. For such kind of other information, you can connect with me in my channel DM Astrology. Do subscribe the channel and do like, share this video or others video. I have done so many videos of Rahu, you can see, just type Rahu and DM Astrology, you will find so many Rahu Dasha, Rahu, 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 so many Rahu video I have done. And I like Rahu because it's nature, and I always like to surrender bow before the nature. So you can contact me in my WhatsApp number here given. For more information, you can see my website www.dmastrology.com. Facebook, you can connect with me in the Dharmesh Mehta or DM Astrology page also you can connect. So all kind of information, whatever I get, time to time I update you, and that is my duty. Thank you very much viewers for listening this, and I hope that you like and you will share this video and make it great success to your life. Thank you. Namaste. Stay blessed.